Here we go.
All right.
Guys, welcome to the brand new NAFT YouTube channel. I'm Jonas, I'm your host, and I'll be telling you about a new car today, the brand new Mercedes S-Class. And what is so special about an S-Class? Well, the S-Class is Mercedes' flagship, and every new generation of S-Class is known to be setting new standards for luxury, safety and technology. And this seventh generation especially had some teasers coming in the last year with crazy innovation, with crazy tech, and I was so curious to learn more about it, and I'm so happy that I can share this with you today. Let's start this review with the interior. No need to talk about the choice of materials, the finish and the quality, because the S-Class is the standard in its class. Okay, personally, I wouldn't go for this beige because I know it'll get dirty, but it gives this car quite the extra luxury look. The seats and steering wheel are wrapped in lovely Napa leather with fancy diamond stitching. They heat, they cool, they massage. They even vibrate, but more on that later. Right, and the eye catcher for me is this crazy 3D screen. It's impossible to film because it uses eye tracking technology and it fakes a 3D depth effect. The crazy thing is that it enables it without needing 3D glasses. So it's just real 3D. I'm looking into a red tunnel right now. So let's set another layout because you have a plethora of layouts here. Yeah, you can customize your dash. For example, if you take the navigation, it is like a 3D plane you're flying over. It's mind-blowing. It's really, really great. I'm not getting headaches. It's not like it's shifting like I've seen before with 3D technology with glasses. It just works. Not only this dashboard screen has the changeable customizable layouts, even the head-up display has different layouts. And the craziest one definitely is the augmented reality mode. So now you can see the augmented reality view, which is combined with the front camera, which shows you the footage of the car where it's going right now, in combination with a 2D map, in combination with a 3D map, in combination with an augmented reality view of those arrows projected right here in front of me on the road. It is crazy. And when looking at the complete dashboard layout, it's surprising to see that the elongated double display layout, as we see in the latest E-Class, has been abandoned, and they've chosen to put in two separate screens again. So there's this dashboard screen, but then there's this separate tablet-like touch OLED brilliant screen. And I can hear some of you say, Tesla, right? Yeah. Also notable is the lack of a big central control module with turning knobs and swipe thingies and buttons. It's now just these monitors in combination with a lot of the buttons that have been moved to the steering wheel. But also, very importantly, the MBUX, the new version of MBUX, the voice assistant. You will be talking a lot to your car. Hey Mercedes.
How can I help?
Switch on a massage.
I'm switching on the massage for you.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Nice. Hey Mercedes, end the navigation.
Cancelling route guidance.
Yeah, it works just perfect. If you compare it with version 1 of MBUX, which I was talking to in Flemish by the way, it never did what I wanted to do. It was unusable, and this is great. Alright, now let's have a look at these menus. In comfort mode, you can set your massages, your seat settings, your ambient lighting. You can have every color you want, or even multicolor shit. But there's also energizing comfort, and energizing comfort stands for a pack of themes like warmth, vitality, joy. So these themes are a combination of soundscapes, light shows, central display animations, also warm or cold air that is being blown through the seat, back and into my butthole, In combination with massages, the seating and the back are slightly moving all the time, and it works because you get revitalized. You get out of this car more energized than you went into the car. It's not all that great. For example, there's the refresh mode, which I think emulates a sea noises and the shore, the wind. But what it does, it's this beautiful theme again with the soundscape. Let's mute this. But there's also a cold wind blowing right into that spot in combination with the seat vibrating. And the combination of those two are really activating my bowel movements. So yeah, there it is. No, I have to switch this off right away because otherwise we have to stop again. Right, so in the center we can find this very spacious center console with, by the way, a wireless charging point. And in front of that there's another space to put your stuff in with another wireless charging point. And this S-Class is wireless Apple CarPlay and Android Auto. Right, let's put on some useful information. Just take a look at all the interfaces, all the graphics, they are so great. By the way, this little button here is a fingerprint sensor. With one touch of this button, you can set the car completely to your liking. But we're in an S-Class, so not only the front occupants are being pampered, there's even two more luxurious seats in the back. The MBUX high-end entertainment system means there's screens in the back everywhere. You can set everything from the back seat. You can set the navigation and send it through to the front of the car. You can change the color, you can set the radio station. There's an HDMI port so you can watch the things you've recorded. You can play PlayStation, you can watch TV, you can surf on the internet. There's a Wi-Fi in the car. The ride in an S-Class, of course, is very quiet. And this makes the standard Burmester 3D sound system sound even better. And as an option, you can go for an extra dimension. There's also the Burmester 4D sound system, I kid you not. And this option makes the seats vibrate along the bass in the music you're playing. By the way, we're now in the short S-Class, still more than 5 meters long. But all in all, in the back there isn't that much legroom if you plan on driving with four big adults. This S-Class has a level 2 steering assistant, which means that it helps me with steering and overtaking. In fact, the car steers itself completely autonomously. I sometimes have to assist the steering a little when driving on a B road to avoid hitting a curb. When there's a sudden turn in the road, it would hit the curb, or it would over adjust when exiting a curve. It would go, yeah. The adaptive cruise control is a real joy to drive. It keeps its distance to the previous car. It also shows this little green markers in the head-up display to show you where the car is. It knows where the car is. And when you have a destination set in your navigation, it'll also automatically reduce the speed when you arrive at the side street you have to go in, so you just have to steer in and the car does the rest. However, this S-Class doesn't always know what the right maximum speed is. For example, when you exit a town center, which is a zone 50, the car thinks you can go 90, but actually you can go 70 in Belgium right now. So you would probably get some fines if you just let this car drive itself. The Belgian law still requires us to keep our hands on the steering wheel, but if you have the optional drive pilot package, in the future, when it is allowed, you can have an over-the-air update which activates fully autonomous driving, so you can check your TikToks and your Instagram feeds without having to look on the road all the time. Nice. By the way, see this? That's the new Mercedes key. And the transmitter in this key is so powerful that when I walk inside my house and the car is parked in front, the car will unlock when I approach, when I'm in a room that's close to the car. So I'm not sure if that is really the most practical thing when you're living in a city. Now let's talk exterior. This generation of S-Class has a lot more of a sporty and dynamic design than its predecessors. I can even see some CLS class lines in this S-Class. What about you? And it actually is a lot more aerodynamic than the previous S-Classes, with, as the party trick, the retracting door handles. And again, I can hear some people think, Tesla! Yep, Our car is on the optional 21-inch rims, which look great. The standard 19-inch wheels just seem a little too small on a car this big. The AMG rear steering axle is an option I can really recommend. It immediately gives you more confidence when navigating this ship through town because it then has the turning circle of an A-Class. And it can even maneuver in and out of parking spots diagonally like crap. How cool is that? The digital light headlights can divide the light in a million pixels, and in that way it can project drawings on the road in front of you. For example, it can project a pedestrian crossing in front of the car.
What?
By the way, we are now in the S350d formatic with a 6-inline diesel engine that makes 286 horsepower. Fast enough. And it actually sounds quite good. This new S-Class has once again surprised me. It is that good, it is that futuristic, it more than lives up to its name to be a luxury and tech trendsetter. I am very impressed and now I want one. These were just a few of the features of the new S-Class, of course. I can talk for hours about this car. And hopefully I'll be able to review another version of this car once the AMG or the Maybach long version comes out. Guys, thank you so much for watching this first NAFT car review. I hope you liked it. Please let me know in the comments. Also, if you have any questions, send me a comment and we'll try and answer them as fast and accurate as possible. I hope my English wasn't too rusty because normally I'm talking in Flemish. You can see that on my other channel, which should appear somewhere here right now. If you like this content, please hit that like button, subscribe to our channel so we can review more, better, faster, more expensive, more exclusive cars, maybe go to some events, meet interesting car people, I don't know. Also, maybe go check out the NAFT website. It's in the description below. They make some really cool apparel, as you can see. This one is of an XJ13 Jaguar prototype, which I'm also personally a big fan of. So that's it for me. I'm Jonas van Gestel, and I hope to see you next time.